Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today, there's going to be a pair of wide receivers looking to make big plays on the field. It's Crabtree's Raiders going up against Benjamin's Panthers. Now we'll take you out to O.co Coliseum, where Jim Nantz and Bill Sims have the call. Panthers, Raiders, coming up on EA Sports, Oakland, California, the site for today's game.
Hello, friends. Jim Nantz along with Bill Sims. And, Bill, it's an absolutely gorgeous day here for football. And how will that factor into this game?
It's always a factor, Jim, when you have good weather. Now you can call anything you want and not worry about the elements disturbing your game plan. It's a complicated game. There's no doubt about it. But it's less complicated when you have good weather.
So that means Fozzie Whitaker will be back for the opening kick. Sebastian Janikowski has it teed up for the opening kickoff. And with that kick, we're underway. And this is Whitaker running it out. And tackles made right around the 26-yard line. Newton's going to march onto the field. The Panthers snap it up at the 26. And now Newton's going to take off. And the pass is thrown away. This offensive line today will be leaned on to protect their quarterback as well as opening up some running lanes. Second down following that incompletion. Sideline inbounds.
What can a defensive back do in a situation like this? The answer is nothing. How about the throw right on target by the quarterback and a good route on an out route by the receiver?
It'll be third down. The Panthers all bunched up here as they get set at the line. Into the hands of Kelvin Benjamin.
You run that drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast, you have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you.
First down at the 38. Stewart's marked down after a gain of 9.
Always a chess match early in the game to see what your opponent is going to do. Good run that time by the offense. They pick up good yards. Maybe the defense will have to start crowding the line of scrimmage more.
Newton has everybody split out wide for the snap.
And a flag.
Billy Brown with the catch. The defense will take the penalty. With the penalty, it's now second down and 11. Stewart's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. That's Newton over to Olsen for the catch.
Now look at all these great tight ends in the NFL now. Makes me think of the NBA. These are power forwards who said to heck with that. They want to be pass catchers, and they're good at it.
Newton lines up in the pistol.
They better hurry to get the snap.
Newton's on the move.
Going for the deep ball. What a catch.
That was a great example right there of what makes Cam Newton so dangerous, running around and then able to make a play.
Well, we know why he was the number one pick in the draft. It's showing more now than ever before. He's learned to throw from the pocket. He can read defenses, and we always knew he could run and throw, and that was a beautiful play.
Play clock's running down.
Newton in shotgun formation. Newton hooks up with Greg Olsen.
Panthers offensive coordinator does a good job that time calling the pass down here in the red zone. Caught the defense off guard. They got the completion for a good game.
Stepping up to the line at the 6-yard line.
The play clock's running down.
Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. Out of the pocket. The Raiders went out and acquired defensive tackle Dan Williams in the offseason, Phil, from Arizona.
Didn't make a big splash around the NFL when you talk about Dan Williams, because he played in Arizona and people didn't realize how good he really is.
This will be the 8th play of this drive. From the gun, Newton. Jonathan Stewart with the catch.
Oh, just a couple inches short of the touchdown. If I was the defense right now, I'd be alert for the quarterback sneak.
First down, offense readying for the snap. Trying to beat the play clock. Handoff. Runs it across for the score. Touchdown. They take the lead here late in the first quarter with the touchdown.
Yeah, nothing like it. Before that first quarter was up, they found a way to get in the end zone and get that score to take the lead. And, hey, that's a good feeling.
The Panthers for the extra point. He made it. Newton certainly given his team some momentum with that scoring drive. He just put together a possession where he threw for more than 60 yards. The Raiders ready to return the kickoff. It's Jones taking a knee, and this will come out to the 20. At quarterback, the young man, there's been a lot of buzz around him at 6'3" out of Fresno State, Derek Carr.
There is nothing not to like about Derek Carr. He has all the tangibles you'd like to see in an NFL quarterback. Strong, big, can run, has a good throwing arm. He's going to do well in the NFL.
First down at the 20. Rivera is able to grab it.
Well, Jim, I always say it's about deception when you're playing offense. That time, the play action fake by the quarterback was so good, the defense didn't even see that he still had the football, and he throws it down there for a nice completion.
First and 10. Murray's going to secure the handoff. Keekley's all over the ball carrier.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
And that's going to do it for the first quarter. We'll be back to Oakland for the start of the second after the break.
Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
The Raiders' offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. Carr's ready for the snap, empty backfield. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
I know it looks easy, but it's not. But a nice throw on the slant route. Slant route means you're slanting towards the inside. Good throw and catch.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Murray's going to take the handoff now. And in for the touchdown.
How about the blocking up front? Lets the running back get in the secondary, and he is so quick and elusive. He avoids the tackles and takes it all the way for the touchdown.
The Raiders with a PAT to tie the contest. The point after is good. The Raiders' kicking team comes out. Their offense now has some time to rest after picking up over 50 yards on the ground on that last drive. Sebastian Janikowski lining up for the kickoff. Webb's going to run this one out. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Raiders' secondary could not stop the pass on the last series.
Well, they were just too timid. They were giving up too much room, making some of the throws too easy for the quarterback. Man, you got to man up, get up there tight, and cover these guys closely.
The Panthers head to the line. Second quarter of a tie game. The score's 7-7. First down at the 28. The ball out, incomplete.
Contreras, one of those guys, if he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
The Raiders go with the dime formation here on defense. Contreras there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. That's his first reception today.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity right on target.
Newton's completion percentage, 70% on the day.
They need to get the playoff.
Newton, handoff.
Well, you can't knock them all down, and sometimes the running back has just got to break a tackle. Good job that time.
Second down here. Ted Ginn has the catch.
Well, here's the cover four defense. Four defensive backs stopping the deep passes down the field, but nobody is there to stop the crossing routes.
They better hurry to get the snap.
Intercepted! How about the timeliness of this interception midway through the second quarter?
Jim, anytime you make an interception on the defensive side, that's a good time, no question. A good time for the defense, the football team. Now we'll see if the offense can take advantage of that.
The Raiders offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for him. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out, and they got it done.
The Raiders take it from the 28. He runs, ball is out. The defense has the football. And he's brought to the ground. A takeaway forced here in the second quarter, and now a chance to take the lead thanks to the defense, Phil.
You said it right. They went out and took the football away. They manhandled the offense. What a good job by the defense.
The Panthers just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches look. You make mistakes on the field, they're going to be forgiving to a point, but you got to be smart, you got to be efficient, and get the job done.
Third catch today so far.
Panthers did a good job that time, throwing a pass on first down and picked up some nice yards. Now second and short, really puts the defense in a tough position.
Play clock's running down to the ground. Stewart's taken down at the 26.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home, they stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
Set up now at the 26. Third down and one. Over to Greg Olsen with the reception. And now we reach the 2-minute warning here in the second quarter. Welcome back. Halftime just a couple of minutes away as we resume play out of the 2-minute warning. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. And gains about one. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
And here's a sneak by Newton.
Jim, I love these situations. Third and goal, what are they going to call? They're going to run the football. They're going to go with a pass. And if it is a pass, I will look for something quick.
Touchdown, Carolina. A big touchdown right there. They're almost sure to take the lead to the locker room with that score.
All touchdowns are big, man. They're all exciting. They all make you feel great. And right now, the offense, they are feeling great about what they did on that last drive.
The Panthers with an extra point try on the way. Inside of the uprights. The Panthers getting ready to kick it away. Jones will run this one out. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. And Charles Johnson heads back onto the field. Their defense has had a lot to do with them getting out to this lead, and he's been the one setting the tone, Phil.
Yeah, Jim, I love the way he plays. He's had a terrific day so far. His toughness, I think that's his greatest quality.
The Raiders take it from the 23. Murray's the receiver on the screen. Harper's all over that offense and brings him down.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up, get that football snap, conserve time, and most of all, conserve that timeout. Those are big down the stretch.
The Raiders signal for the timeout, and that's the first one they've used. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Carr's got it in the gun. It's intercepted. He's brought to a halt.
Keekly's able to show off those great hands and picking off that pass from the linebacker position. What a job and what a pair of hands.
Stewart's not necessarily displayed the kind of dominant running game that we thought we might see today, but they're still in a comfortable position up on the board.
Well, they're winning, and I'm not going to just put all the blame on the offense. Let's give some credit to this defense. They are playing so well, they're not giving up any lanes for the running back to run into.
Double tight end formation. Dixon's got it on a pass that had some heat. That's his first reception today. The Raiders lined up in the nickel. The Panthers snap it at the 26. Away from the ball, there's a flag down on the field. That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. The line of scrimmage, the 36. With a nickel look here on defense. Here's the handoff. Justin Tuck in on the tackle. Second down here after that run play. Stewart is in the backfield. Has Olsen. The Panthers call a timeout. Their first. Offense getting set now following the timeout. From inside the red zone. This play set up by the long gainer. And it's batted down.
It's a nice play that time by the defense. The offense is inside your red zone. You've got to stop them from scoring. That was a good job of swatting the football away.
This will be second down. This will be the last play before halftime. Newton's unable to find his target that time.
When you get third goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
The Raiders with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Third and goal from the 8. Touchdown, Panthers. And a second touchdown on the game.
The late touchdown here in the second quarter gives them a nice lead with the intermission looming, Phil.
Yeah, great job on their side. They got a nice lead, but I just want to give you a little warning. Now, this is professional football, and those are professionals on the other side, and they will fight back. So be ready to come out here and play the same way in the second half.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley.
The Raiders haven't played their best football and trailed because of it. The Panthers have looked good on the road and will just try to keep the ball rolling in the second half.
All right, let's do this. Here's the first half highlights. Panthers take it at the one. Stewart's going to look for space, and he cap off the long drive with the TD. Panthers strike first in this one. First and 10. Murray's got nothing but space here, and he'll win the sprint to the end zone. The Raiders tied up at 7. We go to the second quarter. Quick pass is complete, and he'll end up picking up 13 yards on the play. Panthers will later turn it over on an interception. After the pick, offense comes out now. On the run, the ball comes loose. He'd make it count, running for 31 yards on the play. Offense on the field now after the fumble. Olsen's got the reception, and this five-play drive goes for a touchdown. Panthers up now by 7. Now first and 10. Carr is under fire and will throw the pick. Keekley's reading the play and comes away with it, ending the drive. Third and goal. Completion is made across the middle of the field. And after the short pass, he'll score. That puts them on top by 14. So that's going to wrap up our halftime report. We'll get you back out now to O.co Coliseum with Jim Nantz and Phil Sims are on the call.
All right, Larry, thank you for that from the studios and halftime. We're going to transition now. We're about to get the third quarter underway. Ross is met at the 23. That return's good for about 25. The Raiders are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You've got to go out there and be much better.
To the outside, the catch is made. That's his third catch of the day.
That's a good job by the quarterback. He read the defense, nothing open deep, so he throws it short, and it puts him in great position for a second down play call.
Second and one on the way. The Panthers defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The Raiders from the 32. Got the first, and he's got some space. For the score. Murray's second touchdown of the game.
You don't see a lot of them anymore because we have so many good tackling safeties in the NFL, but not this time. That long run goes for a touchdown. It was about the moves and the blocks down the field. Terrific job by the offense.
The Raiders line up now for the point after. It's good. The Panthers will get their hands on the football again, but their lead is not the same. Things are getting tight here. The scores 21-14. The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. Webb's running this one out. The Panthers will try to continue this scoring onslaught as a shootout has developed on both sides of the field.
I have a little advice for the offensive coordinator. Whatever you're doing it. Keep the pedal to the metal. Your players are playing great, and let them keep rolling.
Stewart lined up in the backfield, trying to power his way right up the middle.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and he only gave up a short gain.
And it'll be second down and six after the running play on first down. The play clock's running down.
Benjamin's going to pull in the bullet pass.
Good job by the offense picking up a first down there. They've been terrific all day long. They're winning the football game, and they are tiring this defense out.
Newton's completion percentage, 70% on the day.
First down coming up. Trying to beat the play clock.
Jonathan Stewart with the football. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short gain.
That last running play was good for only a yard. So it's second down and 9.
Right back to him one more time. Harris is there to make the tackle.
Running backs in the NFL now, it's hard to bring them down. That time, nice job of breaking the tackle.
Coming to the line at the 25.
They bring in the extra tight end. They need to get the playoff.
And there's a drop.
The Panthers go with the pass that time on third and short. The defense was ready, and they stopped the pass. Now we have a fourth down situation.
This will be a 42-yard field goal try. The Panthers call timeout, and they'll have 2 remaining.
That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go.
The offense back out on the field here for this fourth and short play. The Panthers will take the snap from the 25. And it's knocked down.
That was really a tremendous stop on fourth and short by the defense. Now you've got to expect your offense to come out here and take advantage of this situation.
The Raiders take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
Well, it's going to be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy and it was well done by their offense. And I think when you talk about situations like this, it really comes down to one thing. Can the offensive line continue to dominate?
Murray's got it on the handle.
That tackle was made at the 27-yard line.
You see the offensive totals for these teams, and it's been about 2 teams getting it done in different ways.
What we're seeing is 2 different philosophies on the offensive side from these teams here today, Jim. And it doesn't matter. All you want to do is just get it done.
The Panthers come out in a dime package.
Second down and 8.
He's wide open for the grab.
Raiders, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
All right, here we go. Red 18.
First and 10. And Crabtree's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
Barnes able to show off the footwork. Wow, what a good job. Look at those feet.
like a dancer, gets himself in very good position to throw the football.
First down following the long play.
Cooper's got it on the toss.
Here we have second down.
The Panthers' defense now is going to go nickel.
Murray's taking the handoff.
Now makes the move to the right.
And that's a gain of maybe five.
He's got over 130 rushing yards today.
Not much the offense can do in a situation like this. Third and long, what you probably will have to do is either surprise him with a run or throw it short and hope somebody can make a play and pick up a first down.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up.
And that's going to do it for the third quarter. We'll be back to Oakland for the start of the fourth after this.
The Raiders' offense tries to continue some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway.
Third down on the way.
Final quarter underway now with this snap. Middle of the field and incomplete this time.
The Raiders really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Is good. It's good.
And that field goal should help to make this an entertaining fourth quarter.
Well, I have no doubt it's going to be an entertaining fourth quarter, but I thought the coach should have not tried the field goal there that time. I would have gone for it on fourth down and tried to get 7 points.
Sebastian Janikowski lining up for the kickoff.
Whitaker on the return.
And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
The Panthers counted on the passing game early, but it slowed down after a hot start. Newton's tried to adjust to the defense, but it hasn't worked out.
Well, he's tried, but listen, there's nothing he can do about the offensive line. It's not been as sharp, and I'll tell you what, when the offensive line is not sharp, our quarterback's going to lose confidence.
Lofton's the one who made the big stop.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
They better hurry to get the snap.
Newton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap.
Cotchery is there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it.
The Panthers' offense has been tough today. They are fighting out there on the field. That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead them to a score.
First down on the way.
The Raiders' defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense.
Newton in shotgun formation.
That was Woodson on the coverage that time.
Man, the quarterback, the coaches, his teammates, everybody loves to see a player give that type of effort. How about the receiver just going all out to make the catch? Doesn't quite get there, but the effort is outstanding.
An extra tight end on the field for this one.
The Panthers from the 37.
They have this one covered up, and it's going to set them back for a loss.
Interesting situation here for the offense. They got a lead here in the second half, but it's third long. And you always like to say, the football is in the hands of the quarterback, so he has to be smart. If he tries to force it down the field, I do not like his chances.
The Panthers will line up. First down markers right at the 47-yard line. Dixon's got the catch and the first. The Panthers are in front thanks to their quarterback. Newton's done everything he can to keep his team on top.
He has been so efficient here today, very smart, making decisions. And when you put those two things together, that's why your football team is winning.
Coming to the line at the 48.
The Raiders lined up in the nickel. Play clock's running down.
Easy catch there. No one near him. That's his eighth catch of the day.
Olsen's a big target, but he plays that tight end position like he's a wideout, Phil.
Yeah, you know what you see now, Jim? It used to be everything was focused around the wide receiver. He was the number one guy in the passing offense, but now we see many tight ends who are the number one option, just like we're seeing here today.
First down at the 34.
Benjamin's got it on a pass that had some heat.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion. Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
First down at the 15.
Touchdown, Panthers.
Tight ends are a position where you got to be able to do it all. You got to be able to block, run routes, and you got to be able to get in position so you have a chance to catch the touchdown pass. Good job by the tight end. Touchdown.
The Panthers for the extra point.
Driving extra point is good.
The Raiders ready to return the kickoff.
Jones going to take a knee, so this will come out to the 20. The Panthers defense comes out for the start of the new drive after allowing a field goal the last time.
Jim, they hope to play better this time. You take the information that you've learned from the last drive and go out there and correct some of those mistakes.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Takes it from the gun. Looking at every option. Did not get both feet down. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. Of the shotgun. The Raiders get a first down.
When you're behind in a football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays and picking up first downs. Good job by the offense.
Carr's completion percentage 70% on the day.
Welcome back. Coming out of the two-minute warning here in the final quarter. First down. Pressure on every snap now.
All right, here we go. Red 18. Red 18.
The Raiders from the 37. Up the gut here. And that'll be a gain of about two. Second down. Late in the fourth quarter.
You know, you go to the hurry-up offense so you can get a high number of plays in, but also you don't want to use the timeout.
And it's intercepted, which should all but wrap up this game.
Offside. Defense.
The defense, a little jumpy right there. Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way.
Here we go. Red 18. Red 18.
Second down and two. Murray's handed the football. Thompson's the one who brings him to the ground. Now on first down. Every snap crucial the rest of the way. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry. Can't hold on here as it goes incomplete.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Every play is huge now. Second down on the way.
Here we go. Wide and yank. Wide and yank.
Second and 10. Throws the pass. Tried to find his target over the middle, but that pass goes incomplete. And this is a crucial third down play coming up. Third down and 10. Rod Streeter has the reception. A foot rake, and he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run. Clearly, they're not ready to give up the fight just yet, but that touchdown may have come just a little bit too late.
Well, you know, Jim, it's never too late in the NFL. I mean, listen, I remember one time we had a lead late against the San Francisco 49ers. I thought the game was over, and you know what happens. Hey, Joe Montana to Jerry Rice, that's right. I still can remember. He throws a long touchdown to win the game, so you got to hang in there and fight to the end. We wanted more excitement, more tension, more decision making, the second guess in the NFL, and now they're going to have it. This two-point conversion, more teams are going to do it because they don't want to kick the extra point from the 15-yard line.
Coming through in the clutch with a two-point conversion to get within one score in this one.
Yeah, you know, it looks like it would be a simple call down there. You're close to the goal line, just call anything you want, but hard to deceive the defense when you're this close. Nice job that time by the offense.
They have been fighting an uphill battle, and they had to recover that onside kick.
Well, it's a tough spot for them, Jim. We know that. You're going for the onside kick, and you're trying to recover it. I think your chances are about 1 out of 10, and that time it was not on their side.
The Panthers' offense would like to drive for another touchdown, only they would like to think that this time it won't go to waste and their defense might step up at some point here, Phil.
Well, all they can do is just go out there and score again. Don't worry about your defense. Don't start thinking about that. Worry about your job, what you're doing on the offensive side, because what you have been doing has been terrific.
The Panthers have it at the 39. Gets it out for the completion. Gains 15. The Raiders will stop the clock here with this timeout, needing to preserve time. First down here.
Handoff to Jonathan Stewart.
Stewart's marked down after a gain of 4. The Raiders will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point.
Everybody's back out on the field now after that defensive timeout.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
2nd and 6. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. The Raiders stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second. Now 3rd and short following the run. The Panthers, 1 timeout remaining. That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go.
Coming to the line at the 15-yard line.
3rd and 1. Back to the ground. Stewart's going to pick up the first down as he's tackled. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Jim, no surprise there. You got the lead. It's late in the game. You run the football. Make that clock keep ticking. And you go over these situations so many times in practice. You got to manage the clock. Know how much time you got left. They've done that well. And just keep running it.
1st and goal from the 10. Breaking huddle at the 12-yard line. This was a close one. It came down to the wire. What's that feeling on the sideline right now on the winning side?
Oh, it's awesome. When games are close, you're down on the sideline. You look up there every once in a while and you go, oh, I hope we can find a way to win this game today. They did it. It is truly extremely exciting once you get it done.
Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nantz, saying so long.